Hello everyone, welcome to the Northwest Open. Day three is traditionally moving day. I'm Luke Elvey, great to have your company as John McCarthy and I take you through the action.
Hi Luke, glad to be here. What's happening?
Well John, there's a great atmosphere here today. The crowd sounds like they're up for it and I'm looking forward to seeing some fantastic golf.
Thanks Luke, we'll talk to you after nine holes. And he had a great previous round. Let us see what happens today. Yeah, I think you'll like that. And about 145 yards to the pin. And here's an 8-iron. And I think he's gonna like that. Oh my goodness, just missed. This one looks about 4 feet. And that one drops for par. And starting today's round off at even par. And now setting up for this par five. It's looking like it's heading into the fairway. From here, 220 to the pin. Going with the 3-iron. And I think he will be happy with that. And that will drop for the eagle. And he will move up on the leaderboard after that hole. Now let's see what this third hole has in store. And this for the birdie. And the putt will drop. and 3 under for the day after that one. All right, here's the fourth hole. One's heading for the green. And this putt is for birdie. Let's see how things are shaping up on the leaderboard. And after that one, he's going to share the lead for this event. Teeing off on this next hole, the wind could come into play. Let's find out. Ellison's looking pretty good. Okay, and 135 yards to the pin. Here's a pitching wedge. And the shot's looking pretty good. And 13 feet to go here. And after that one, nothing's changing here. He's still tied for first. And next up is a par four, folks. Well, you'll probably like that. And about 13 feet away here. And that one will go for birdie. And no change in his standings after that hole. Let's see what the seventh hole has in store today. I think he'll like that. And about 115 yards to the pin. And this putt is essential for saving par. And after that one, he's still managing to hold on to first place. See how this one goes. They're setting up below the hole. Looks like a 7-iron. And that is not bound for the dance floor. I think the wind got the best of that. About 7 feet to go here. Ooh, and it just misses. And this one for bogey. Finishing this hole with a solid putt. And currently sitting at 4 under for the day. And on to the 9th hole. Okay, this one's looking pretty good. And about 105 yards to the pin from here. And that one is on the green with quite a bit of real estate to make up on that next putt. Oh my goodness, close, very close, but no cigar. This one's about 2 feet from the cup. And as he finishes up his front nine, Luke, he's found himself in a pretty good place to be.
Well, it's always great having the lead, John, but this player doesn't want to switch off because there's going to be a bunch of players wanting to come at them if they're trying to win the championship.
Thanks for that, Luke. Okay, and the 10th hole. Through the brush on this one. Yeah, he's probably not happy about that shot. Well, at least this lie will be better than the last. This one's about a 7-footer. and finishing this hole out with a solid putt. And no change for him leaderboard-wise after that hole. And just about to tee off on this par 3. Taking a shot with the pitching wedge. And with that, he's on the green. And this for the birdie. And just missing. And for the par. And after that one, 4 under is the score for the day. And now setting up for the next par 4 hole. And nothing wrong with that shot. This is about 20 feet away. Ooh, that was very close. This one's about 9 feet away. And finishing the hole with a solid putt. And he will stay right where he is on the leaderboard after that hole. All right, let's see what happens on the 13th hole here. Wow, look at this drive, folks. Serious power. And this one's a 36-foot putt. Oh my, and that was just fun to watch. And after that one, currently sitting at 5 under for the day. And setting up now on the 14th tee. From here, about 195 yards to the pin. Yeah, it looks like a 5-iron. And he's got to be happy with that. And this one's for birdie. And that putt drops. And after that one, he will stay at the top of the leaderboard. And moving on to the 15th hole. And nicely done, looking like we'll have some fairway here. I think he'll like that. And this putt is for birdie. And a nice putt there. And he's going to stay right there where he was on the leaderboard. No change in the ranking. And setting up for the par 5 hole. And nothing wrong with that shot. Okay, and hitting this par 5 in 2 is going to set up some definite eagle possibilities. Unfortunately, the golf gods have spoken, and the eagle is not going to happen. And tapping in for birdie. And after that one, sitting at 8 under par for the day. And that also means he is in first place on the leaderboard. And number 17. I think that's a 5-iron. Well, that was an unfortunate approach. Just not enough club on that one. This putt is needed to save par. Ooh, that one's, that's too bad. And this putt is for bogey. And he's still in first place after that hole. And now teeing up for the final hole of the round. Well, this one's looking like it's finding the fairway. And from 155 yards out. Going with the pitching wedge here. And I think this is looking a bit long. And not the best approach shot. It's too much club. This putt's about 13 feet from the cup. Ooh, and that was very close. Just didn't drop. And this putt's about a 2-footer here. And at the end of this third round, he winds up in first place. And Luke, not a bad place to be.
Great playing so far from this player. They've certainly earned their position on top of the leaderboard. But there is work to be done, John. Don't rest on your laurels. Well, on behalf of John, I'm Luke. Catch you again tomorrow. Thank you.